I knew that my mission would continue. And I knew that all these things that I had learned, that my mission, again, was a growth period. And it was a time for me to, like, learn all these things so that I could put it into practice, right? Like, that was the whole point of my mission, was so that I could, like, live the rest of my life as a consecrated disciple. Like, just putting all of the things that I'd learned and the gifts that I'd been given, like, putting those into practice. But I loved every day of my mission. And it was, the last day was hard. I was in Cambridge, and so my poor companion, I was like, okay, this is what I want to do. I want to get on the T, and I left in winter, so I was in a student ward, so literally everyone was out of town, right? So I was just like, all I want to do today is get on the T, and we're going to get off at every stop, and we're going to go to a new car of the T, and we're going to talk to everyone on the car. And then at the next stop, we're going to get off and go to the next car and talk to everyone in that car, and we're just going to do that, and then come back and do the same thing on the way back. My poor companion's like, okay, whatever. So we just got on the T and just talked to people just for a couple of hours before I had to go to the mission home and have, like, my final transfer meeting. But I remember that last day being really surreal and just feeling like I'm leaving a big chunk of my heart in Boston. Like, getting on that airplane, like, from Boston to Salt Lake City, like, I just looked out the window and cried my heart out. I just felt like I am leaving home. I'm leaving Zion. and it was really hard, but it was also just a recognition of what a sacred gift it was. And that, like, it wasn't about me, but that God had granted me this incredible gift. And I felt like, when I went to the temple, that's one of the things my mission did, is we got to go to the temple at the beginning of our mission and kind of, you know, promise the Lord what kind of missionary we'd be. And then at the end, you got to go again and, like, your day of reckoning, like, what did you do? And I just remember feeling really accountable. I just felt like I had learned a lot of things, and the Lord had given me just amazing gifts. And I just felt like, okay, now's the time. Like, the training wheels are off. I don't have the luxury anymore of, like, this missionary schedule. I don't have the luxury of, like, having a companion all the time. There are a lot of things about a mission that are just really nice. It makes it really easy to be consecrated and to have Zion. And then the training wheels come off, and you don't have those luxuries anymore, but you're doing the same things. Like, you still are being consecrated, and you're still building Zion. And I remember just sitting there in the temple feeling like, I don't know. I was kind of like, okay, was my mission acceptable? Like, you know, are you okay with me right now? And it was, I don't know. I kind of felt like the Lord was not reprimanding me, but it was kind of like, okay, like, sure, your mission was great, like, pat on the back, like, yeah, you did a good job, but, like, if you think that's the end, like, think again. You, like, all of this is so that you can live the rest of your life now as a disciple. And I think that's one thing that really changed my perspective on my mission, is thinking about it like long-term goals, like being obedient. That I was like, we're not just obedient because the White Handbook says we're supposed to be obedient, and we're not just obedient so that we can, like, do the right thing. Like, I'm obedient so that I can, like, look my kids in the eye someday and be like, I was an obedient missionary. And not just for that, but, like, it impacts everyone. Like, it impacts the spirit that you have with your companion. It impacts the spirit that the members feel from you. It impacts the way that you interact with other missionaries. And it definitely impacts the rest of your future. Like, the spirit that you carry with you from how you lived as a missionary is, like, forever. You are always going to have the memories of, like, how you chose to conduct yourself and what you chose to do and not do, as a missionary. And I guess just realizing, like, kind of switching my mindset from, like, okay, my mission, of just realizing that, like, this is training for life. Your mission is not just your mission. Like, you don't want to just have blinders on of, like, okay, I'm going to, like, do my mission thing, and then I'm going to go back to life. Like, that's not it at all. Like, you're missing the whole point. Like, the whole point of a mission is you're training to be a disciple, a consecrated disciple of Jesus Christ, and just figuring out how to, like, I don't know, get that mindset that I am training for life. I am so accountable for the things that I'm learning here. And, like, all of these things are transferable. All of these things are going to apply to the rest of my life. Like, I'm learning how to be a member missionary. I'm learning how to minister to people. I'm learning, like, I'm never going to miss a month of visiting, teaching. Like, I'm never going to do anything less than the best I possibly can do on a calling. Like, I'm always going to pray. I'm always going to read my scriptures. Just learning that this is life, and looking at your mission, not just as, like, okay, my mission, but looking at mission as, like, okay, this is life. Like, this is what it means to be a disciple of Jesus Christ. And that is a life calling. Like, the work of salvation is the work of your life. And it's everything. Like, nothing else matters. Nothing else is important. Like, everything that is important, everything that does matter comes under the umbrella of the work of salvation. And just figuring that out was essential for me.